It's late at night, and I'm getting onto the subway with my girlfriend at the time. And we step onto the subway, and as we're walking onto the train, I mention 19th century German Chancellor Otto von Bismarck. Because I know how to seal the deal. And we walk onto the train, and right across from us, there's a homeless gentleman asleep, standing up in the style of a horse. That's how they do it. That's how he did it. And when and that wasn't the moment that I felt at home. I wasn't like, let me join you, Father, right? It was, that's just where it starts. So we walk onto the train, and when I mention Otto von Bismarck, the 19th century Chancellor of Germany, he wakes up, stares me in the eyes, and engages me in debate. Like, we're a one-on-one debate society, and my time is up. And I expected him to have kind of the standard homeless gentleman voice, right? Like Tom Waits on his Tom Waitsiest day. But he didn't. He had this beautiful, rich baritone. And when he spoke to me, this is what he said, verbatim. He goes,
"There were no chancellors in those days. Otto von Bismarck was the king of Germany. He unified the Germanic people, but he scattered Africa. That is the legacy of Otto von Bismarck."
Then he fell back to sleep, standing up, like Abraham Lincoln at Disney World's Hall of Presidents, leaving me to wonder, is that what he says to everyone that gets on the train? And I just brought up the topic he was gonna discuss anyway. I did not have to worry. My girlfriend woke him up to ask a follow-up question, which until that point was the thing I thought she only did to me. She says, "Excuse me, how did you have that knowledge at your fingertips, waking up from a dead sleep in that way? How did you come by this expertise? That was amazing." And he said,
"I studied in England. I studied in France. I was a professor here at Monroe College in the Bronx. But now, look at me. Here I am, homeless and an alcoholic, asleep on this train with my two ladies."
And we look around, and there's nobody else on the train. Then he opens his jacket. He's got Jack Daniels on one side, Johnny Walker on the other, which to me didn't look like ladies, but gender's a spectrum, and I wasn't there to judge.